And firstly, I would like to welcome on stage Team Test from the Netherlands.
Good afternoon. As we both know, you are a severe heart failure patient. And for patients like you, we have developed a new tool. It's a tool that will help you monitor your disease at home. Would you like to try it?
That sounds great. Does it mean that I don't have to go to the hospital anymore?
Yes, it will keep you out of the hospital.
That will be a nice improvement. How does it work?
I will give you an analyzer and some cartridges, and you will have to perform a finger prick twice a week. You insert a droplet of blood inside the cartridge and the cartridge inside the device. Then in 10 minutes time, the result of your NT-proBNP level will be known, and an app on your smartphone keeps track of the development over time. And this app also allows me to keep an eye on you.
Thank you. I would like to use that. In this case, I just pretended to be a patient with severe heart failure. And by doing that, I represented over 100,000 patients in the Netherlands who belong to the New York Heart Association classes 3 and 4. Our interviews with cardiologists showed that these patients will benefit most of a biosensor like we are developing. We conducted a survey among heart failure patients in the Netherlands with the following results. It turned out that the main requirement of the patients was the user friendliness of the device. And we could imagine that a finger prick might be bothersome, but our survey showed that over 91% of the patients experiences a finger prick as not bothersome. What we learned from the cardiologist is that they would like to have to get a better insight in the time evolution of the NT-proBNP levels of the patients. With our biosensor, we enable patients to measure, for example, twice a week without going to the hospital. And besides that, the cardiologist emphasized the need for a conclusive status update of the patients. And therefore, we will connect our biosensor to an existing health platform that will also ask for the patient weight and how the patient feels.
We have estimated the cost price of our product by considering the cost price of the parts that it's made of. So as you can see, or if you cannot read it, please come by our poster, then we will have a closer look at it. Based on advice from sensor manufacturers, we have tripled the cost price to arrive at our selling price, which is 500 euros for the analyzer and 1 euro for the cartridge. And with that price, we have a very good position on the market because the other our competitors are much more expensive. So because we are so not expensive, this enables home sensing. But before we can truly enter the market, we still have some work ahead. For now, we are going to work on even further miniaturization of our technology, and we are going to work on seamless integration into the existing health platforms. Eventually, we are also going to do realistic trials with patients and cardiologists, get our CE certification, and then we estimate that we are able to enter the market in 2022. And we will target the Dutch market, in which each year 450 million euros is spent on hospitalization of heart failure patients. And our telemonitoring system, which targets these 100,000 patients, will only cost 100 million euros. So let's say we can prevent, for example, 50% of the hospitalizations, then we would save the Dutch society 225 million. But we will already be positive saldo if we can prevent only 1 in 4. And this is taking into account heart failure patients only, but our technique can be made fit for other biomarkers with only minor changes. Now let's get back to one of our patients. Well, good to see you again. You have been monitoring your health for a while now. How do you like it?
I really like it so far. The device is fast and small and it keeps me out of the hospital.
That's good to hear. I have one last question for you. Would you like to share your data with researchers? Anonymized, of course.
Yes, that's no problem for me.
Okay. Well, good to hear. And Lotte is not the only patient. About 60% of the patients that we held our survey amongst were also willing to share their data with researchers, which will allow us to get better insight in the disease. And with that knowledge, we can all benefit. Thank you for your attention, and we would like to thank our sponsors and advisors.
Thank you very much for the presentation. Are there any questions? Yes, of course.
Well, then we will not make profit, so...
No, if you sell it for 20 euros, the cartridge, I mean.
Oh, the cartridge. Yeah, we really want to enable patients to monitor at home, so that's very different than the sensors that are already on the market. And if you want to measure 2 times a week at home, and this will cost you 40 euros per week, then it won't save society that much if you prevent hospitalization for, of course. So we don't see that as our goal. We want to make it as accessible as possible. Any other questions? Yes?
I think it is really great that you ask patients how they felt about your method. Where did you get those patients?
Yeah. So the question is, where did we find the patients to fill in our questionnaires about our product? We contacted the Patients Association from Heart Failure, and they helped us spread our questionnaire amongst those patients. And since we live in a digital world, that went really quickly. So we were really happy with the help from the Hart and Vaat group. Yeah. Other questions? Yes?
I don't know if you mentioned that at the beginning. Did you measure the plasma now?
Yes.
So how are you going to get the plasma from your person if he takes blood draw from a pulmonary or something? You don't have plasma yet?
Yeah, we will work on a built-in filter, which will filter all the big red blood cells and the white blood cells, for example, so that in the reaction chamber only the plasma will reach it. More questions? Yeah?
Who will pay for the device? Patient, hospital?
Okay. Yeah. So the question is, who will pay for the device? We are going to do clinical trials, for example. And via that way, we will try to convince everyone that our sensor is, that it works and that it saves money. And in that way, we hope that we can become eligible for inclusion in the Dutch healthcare system. And then the patient wouldn't have to pay it, the insurance companies will.
Thank you very much for the presentation. A round of applause, please.